Hi children, welcome to the chemistry class, elements and compounds. In the 7th standard, the first chapter is elements and compounds. So let's see what are the elements and what are the compounds. So what is an element and compound? A chemical substance is a form of matter having constant chemical composition and characteristic properties. Some references add that chemical substances cannot be separated into its constituent elements by physical separation method without breaking chemical bonds. Without breaking the chemical bonds, only with the, if the physical separation happens, then the chemical bonds between them in a matter will not happen. So, a chemical substance is a form of matter having constant chemical composition and the characteristic properties, that is physical properties and chemical properties. So, here some references says that chemical substance cannot be separated and physical separation element, that is without breaking the chemical compounds. So substances are pure and impure substances, but here in this chapter you are learning elements and compounds. Elements and compounds are derived from pure substance. Elements again divided into metals and non-metals, metals and non-metals, compounds into metalloids, and pure substance and impure substance are mixtures. Okay, so substances are of two types, pure substance and impure substance. Pure substance again divided into elements and compounds, and the impure substance into mixtures. Okay, impure substance into mixtures. Here elements again divided into two, that is metals and non-metals. Compounds are derived to metalloids. Classification of pure substances. Pure substances, as we discussed, there are two types. One is element and compound. Element and compound. So they are separated into simpler substances. Pure substances are again divided into simpler substance. So pure substance made up of one type of atom, that is one type of atom. Some elements found as a multi-atom molecules in nature. And these atoms combine together to make a compound. See here, atoms, they combine together form a compound. And compounds made up of one type of molecule or array of ions or array of ions. Units contain two or more different kinds of atoms. In the element, there will be only one type of atom, and this atoms combines with the together form a compound. But in compound, they are made up of one type of molecule, and again they contain two different kinds of atoms. See elements, if you see a helium, that is a gas where it contains only one type of atom, but these atoms combine together form a compound. But here water, see, it is having one molecule, that is what, water molecule. So water molecule contains two different kinds of atoms. What are those atoms? Hydrogen atoms. See, what is the formula of water? H2O. So it is having one oxygen and two hydrogen atoms, that is oxygen combines with two hydrogen, that is why units contains two or more different kinds of atoms. Next, see, matter classified into pure substance and impure substances. Pure substance, elements and compounds. Impure substance, mixtures. And pure substance, elements, example, hydrogen, carbon. Compound, water, ammonia. So, hydrogen, H2, carbon, C, water, H2O, ammonia, NH4. And elements again classified into metals, non-metals, metalloids, noble gases. Metals like silver, gold, iron. Next, non-metals, sulfur, zinc, calcium. And metalloids, arsenic, mercury. Noble gases, hydrogen, helium, sorry, helium, lithium are the examples of noble gases. That is zero group elements. You know, zero group inert gases, helium, lithium, beryllium, krypton, xenon, radon. Next, impure substance mixtures, homogeneous mixture, heterogeneous mixtures. Homogeneous mixture contains same type of mixture, and heterogeneous contains different type of mixtures. Next, in chemistry, an element is a species of atom having the same number of protons in its atomic nuclei. For example, the atomic number of oxygen is 8, so that the element oxygen describes the all atoms which have 8 protons. In chemistry, an element is a species of atom. In chemistry, an element is a species of atom having same number of electrons, protons in its nuclei, that is same atomic number. For example, atomic number of oxygen is 8, so oxygen describes all atoms which have 8 protons. So in totally, in periodic table, it is having 118 elements have been identified, but the first 94 that occurs naturally on the earth, and the remaining 24 are synthetic elements. That means those are man-made, man-discovered. There are 80 elements that have at least one stable isotope, and 38 have radionucleotides, and which decay over time into other elements. Like iron is the most abundant element upon the earth, while oxygen is the most common element in the earth crust. Isn't it, children? Without oxygen, the earth crust will not be there for all the plants and animals. For plants, CO2 is required, and for animals, oxygen is required. It is very essential element on the earth. So totally, how many elements we have? 118 elements. And among this, 94 are naturally occur in the nature, and remaining, that is 24, are synthetic elements. So from where this element is used? The term element is used for atoms with a given number of protons where they are ionized or chemically bonded. So if you see an element, it will be having plus or minus. That is what? Ionized. So the term element is used for atoms with a given number of protons, with a given number of protons, whether or not they are ionized or chemically bonded. For example, hydrogen in water, as well as a pure chemical substance consisting of a single element, hydrogen gas. Chemical symbols are abbreviations used in chemistry for chemical elements, functional groups, and chemical compounds. See, you know, symbols are very important, and that will be given to an element. A symbol is very important and it is very attractive, and it is given to identify the elements easily. So chemical symbols are abbreviations used in chemistry because for the chemical elements, functional groups, and chemical compound. Element symbols for chemical element normally consist one or two letters from the Latin alphabet and are written with the first letter should be capitalized, and it was given by the IUPAC, International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry. So we'll study this in detail in the next class. Thank you, children.